After modeling both the annotation and the graphic organizer for her sixth graders, Ms. Hoard has them work independently on the same tasks. Then they discuss their findings in small groups.
It has rights.
It was purchased in ancient Egypt in 1920, and it was 167 meters long. What did you think about the coffin?
Okay, yeah, like maybe how they
had like symbols around here. Do they copy her face? Because it shows her face. Is that how her face looked?
It's important to provide students with multiple layers of support when doing close reading of a text.
I heard some great conversations out there. So, let's talk about your experience with this text. Some of you were struggling, so let's work through it together and make sure that we're feeling good about this. So, for the first part about the key idea, would anyone like to share what they figured out about what is the key idea for this section of the text? Jennifer?
This is about the brief inscription on her coffin that states her name and gives her title, and also that her tome is lost and unknown.
Okay, so Jennifer said a lot in her key idea statement. You want to make sure that you don't include too many details in your key idea, or then you've given all the details, right? We want to make sure that our key idea statement is a pretty short one. This is basically about what?
What the coffin looks like.
Yeah. Other thoughts on that? Did anybody do it a little differently? Jennifer, I like how you worked that out. Monica, what do you think?
Marissa Moon is known for her coffin and mummy.
All right. What I noticed about what Monica did is she mostly drew her key idea statement from where? Gustavo?
The first sentence.
The first sentence. Have you guys noticed that sometimes in an informational text, a lot of times actually, the first sentence will kind of give you a key idea?
Yeah.
Yeah? So that's a great place to look for a key idea. I like how you did that. Great. So, what details do they give about that coffin? What details are included in this section? Let's hear some of the details. Monica?
It has a brief inscription.
What does the inscription tell? Monica?
The name and her name and the title of what she worked for.
Yeah, her name and the title of her job, right? That's kind of interesting. Do we put our names and our title of our job on our coffins now?
No.
When I die someday, is it going to say Jody Hoard teacher on my coffin?
No.
Where would that information maybe be? Ivan, where might you find that information?
Like on your tombstone?
Yeah, like on my tombstone, right? So I'm thinking it's kind of like what we would put on a tombstone in ancient Egypt. They might have put that on the coffin instead. That's kind of interesting, huh? Any other details about the coffin that you read in this section?
Once the students have shared supporting details, it's important to have them go a step further to see if they can infer information from the text.
Did anybody infer anything about life in ancient Egypt from what they read in this section of the text? Xavier?
Many other ordinary Egyptians might have had a coffin that was high as Mirajnam's, but not as decorative.
Like, okay. Oh, interesting. Why do you say that?
Because hers was like, she was known for that. If they did it on other coffins, then they would be like, this Marissa Moon or is this Marissa Moon?
Interesting.
They would be questioned.
So he's thinking maybe this is kind of a special coffin. Maybe they're not all like that. We might find more about that as we continue to read. Good thinking. Nice, guys. Nice work.